ay napakinggan natin ang pananaw ng mga kinatawan ng iba't ibang sektor. Ngayon po ay mapakinggan natin ang recollection. Kung hindi man gunita ng ating mga panauhin na naglingkod bilang mga mambabatas.
It's been quite some time since we heard of Senator Kuya Eddie Ilarde, who was a member of the 7th Congress. And it's a pleasure to have with us Senator Vic San Andres Ziga at si Senador Kit Tatad. They come from different eras. Hindi po yung internal revenue allotment, no? Era, panahon, no? Sa paglilingkod sa ating bansa. Hindi po makararating si Senador Nene Pimentel. Sana nakasama natin. At narito rin po naman ang isang batang-batang profesor ng Political Science de La Salle University. Dati pong nasa Ateneo to eh, pero ngayon nasa La Salle na. Isang manunulat at regular na kolumnista sa mga ahensyang pandaigdig at think tank organizations, si Professor Richard Heydarian. Simula po natin ang ating talakayan. Pababatiin natin at bigyan natin ng pagkakataon yung ating mga kasama to recall what the SONA was during their time. Manong Eddie, kayo po ang pinaka-senior na mambabatas na kasama natin ngayon. Please share with us your thoughts about the State of the Nation address during your time.
Thank you, Melo. Pero bago yan, nabanggit mo senior, pinaka-senior. Ayokong aminin yan, but I think it shows, no? nabanggit mo senior, I'd like to give you my book. The greatest book ever written. The Book of Seniors.
The Book of Seniors. Wow. Thank you very much.
Okay, Melo. Kaya namin naisulat ito sapagkat we have 10 million seniors in this country and counting. And di man dapat ay sasabihin ko dito na kami po ay nagpadala ng mungkahi sa kasalukuyang presidente na mag-set up siya ng commission for senior citizens. Sapagkat meron tayong mga commission on all. Commission for the youth, commission for this, commission for that. But we don't have a commission for senior citizens. It is an admonition of the United Nations several years ago that governments should have infrastructures and should do something to help the graying population of the world. So we wrote this. It's not that because I consider you senior, Melo, but for you to read it.
That's a nice one.
Marami kang matututunan dyan when you become a senior citizen.
Yeah, I will also give a copy if you still have an extra to Yudai, because Japan has a growing gray population too.
Don't worry. I gave one of the copies to Emmy. And Emmy maybe will translate that to Japanese.
Very good. Advanced thinking. Very
si
nice.
Si Melo, mga kaibigan, ay isa sa mga hinahangaan kong media man na mas nakababata sa akin. Napupuna ko na kumo siya ay isang uragon din. Ang kanyang inimbita dito ay tatlong uragon na naalala ko tuloy yung sinabi ng isang kaibigan na there was a time when there were, I think, 7 senators from Bicol, including my compadre, Kit Tatad, and my manay, Tekla San Andres Ziga, and the son, Vic, no? Kung kayong mga Bicolano lang ay hindi imik, this country will be at peace.
Ganun.
Oh. ngayon, tatlo kami nandito ngayon, Melo. You are not going to be at peace, that's for sure.
And that's what we'd like to hear from you.
Thank you very much, Melo. Alam po ninyo, ang SONA, maraming hindi nakakaintindi kung ano ang SONA. Tayong mga Pilipino, mahilig tayo na buuin ng acronym. Ang Epifanio de los Santos, sabi nyo, ginawang EDSA. Ang State of the Nation Address, ginawang SONA. Ang naalala kong SONA, Melo, mga hindi pa kayo pinapanganak siguro, ay nakakatakot nung panahon ng digmaan. Sapagkat pag sinabi mong may SONA, yung mga Hapon ay paliligiran ng isang baryo, yun ang gagawing SONA at maraming huhulihin. Without meaning to denigrate the Japanese. I had a sensei who was very fond of me. That's why I was the best Nippongo speaker during that time. And my sensei told me that I'm very fond of you, Eddie Irarode. Ilarde, because the Japanese pronounce it bisyllable. Irarode-san, I like you because you look like my son in Tokyo during the time. When I became a member of Congress, I went to Tokyo to look for him, only to be told very sadly that he died in Bicol during the war. But I was able to meet his brother, and we exchanged pleasantries, and he ended up crying because we both remember Unishi-sensei. Mm-hmm. So about Sona, nung araw kinatatakutan yan. Now, during my time, I will not say during our time, because I was ahead a few years than Vic here, and my compadre Kit Tatad, whom I so admire, and I'm his fan, even when he was in Malacanang. And nauna ko, ang Sona nung araw, nung panahon namin, Melo, 90% true and 5% fiction. Eh ngayon, ang Sona, nabaliktad. 90% fiction, only 5% true. And ituloy ninyong palakpakan.
What made you say that?
Because Sona these days is a lot of ritual and expense signifying nothing. Ang nakakaalam ng kalagayan ng nasyon natin ay ang mga mamamayan. Pagdating sa presidente, gagandahan na niya, lalagyan na niya ng mga palamuti at gagawin na niya na 90% fiction and only 10% true. So, iyan ang pagkakaiba. At ang kinahinatnan ng Sona ngayon ay red carpet.
Towards the end of her term, in fact, the Senate, we only had 5 Sonas because the term was for the resynchronization of the election. You remember? The congressman, which had 3 years, became 6 years or 5 years, and the Senate, which had 6 years, just became
3 years.
5 years.
Oh, yeah, okay.
Just to synchronize it all in 1992.
Okay.
But this coming Sona, I am so, as Kuya Eddie said, you do not need to listen to the president this afternoon. Do you know the state of the nation? You just look around you now. Every day you look around you. That's the state of the nation we are looking at. Long lines in the MRT.
Mm-hmm.
The poor all around us. The hunger.
Even the airports, no?
The airports congestion.
During your trips to the Bicol region?
My trips, sometimes we are flying around Manila or in the province for 2 or 3 hours waiting for clearance to land. That is the congestion. If there is traffic in EDSA, there is also traffic in the air.
Mm-hmm.
And you are endangering all these passengers.
Mm-hmm. And not to include human trafficking.
Human trafficking, as I was just listening, there was somebody who told me that before there were 3,000 Filipinos leaving our country every day. And just this morning I heard 6,000 now leave Manila every day
for abroad. And we're worried whether these 6,000 who leave daily for abroad would still vote come 2016.
Yes.
And or somebody else would vote for them.
We are worried whether they will be treated properly abroad.
That's another thing.
Whether they will be abused, etc. And whether they will come back in a coffin.
That's a problem. Thank you very much. Senator Kit, from where you were at the Senate, how would you recall this?
It's a pleasure to be here, Melo, as usual, no? Pero mag-umpisa tayo dun sa sinabi ni Kuya Eddie. It's a very important issue. It's a very important demographic issue because by the year 2025, the majority of the world's population will be 60 and above. We will become the majority. By the time, we should be about 200 years old, no? But we would be part of the majority. So, and this will become you know, a stronger reality, because you have big countries like the United States where same-sex marriage has come in. There'll be no children. People will just be growing old. Huh? Think of that. That's the glorious future.
What a way to describe it.
Yeah. Yeah. You know.
Glorious.
Wala. Alang problema. But to get back to the SONA. I wrote in my column this morning, those of you who do not read the Manila Times, the handsomest picture on the front page is mine.
Okay. Yeah, we agree.
And my column today is 5 years of madness while the people suffered, Aquino grew in humbug and hubris. That's my assessment of the situation, no? Mm-hmm. Tiglao, who also writes on the same page, but he does not have his picture. No?
Okay. So that's something. Okay.
Says, Aquino is the worst president ever. No? And I think this is the judgment of many people. After Cory, we thought she was the worst president we ever had. But I think her son saved her. He now has the distinction. But he's messing up everything. And if he succeeds in messing up this election, his administration is going to be much better than the next one.
Why did you say so?
I said so.
Why? Are there telltale signs?
Because, you know, first, we had bogus elections in 2010 and 2013. Now, they're insisting on having the same kind of elections. They still want Smartmatic, in spite of the fact that, according to the auditor's report in London, Smartmatic Limited was the one that authorized this audit. Smartmatic team in the Philippines, like all Smartmatic operations in other parts of the world, is 100% foreign-owned. Ergo, they haven't got the constitutional authority to be present in this country, to operate in this country. They don't even if it turns out that they are a 60-40 corporation as required by Philippine law, they don't even have a license to operate in 2013. Apparently, their term of reference allows them to operate in 2010 and 2013, but not beyond.
Really?
So, we want to focus a little on that. The need for genuine elections, and we may not have it. More than that, Pinoy is trying to impose a bogus presidential candidate. Someone who is not even a natural-born Filipino, which is a requirement of the Constitution. So if that happens, we have to start looking for another country. My friend from Japan, will you consider applicants from Richard from Iran? Probably. Mm-hmm. We should start looking, no? But as everyone has said earlier, I don't expect anything from SONA except for this show. No? It's a fashion show for the shallow-minded ladies there wearing all sorts of garish things. Nothing. And Pinoy will deliver his ghostwritten speech reading the teleprompter. And until now, some people believe that wala siyang binabasa, no?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. That's how ignorant we become.
During our time, there was no teleprompter.
Wala. The teleprompter came in with Nixon, I think, no? And Marcos' time, we didn't have... I was Minister of Information for 10 years. We didn't have this. Towards the end of my term, I recommended you acquire that gadget which Nixon uses when he delivers a speech. And that's the time they got it in Malacanang. And I think Pinoy is putting it to very good use. Okay. Now, Marcos had, I think, the most number of SONAs.
Oh, yes, of course.
Yeah, 30, I think. 30 or so. Because he was there for 20 years.
Mm-hmm.
He should have stayed for another 50 years. And we would have been much better.
Anyway.
Each SONA was carefully crafted to report not only the so-called achievements, but the problems. The presidency is problem-solving. You have to identify the problems so that there will be solutions to these problems. Now, these things do not exist anymore. You have audiovisuals, no? People, warm bodies are introduced into the speech. Parang all the consolation prizes are distributed, no? Pinagagalitan yung kailangan pagalitan. Somebody told me, a businessman, in a stockholders meeting, the chairman does not, castigate anyone who has done anything wrong. This is an internal matter, no? This one, yun ang paboritong gawin niya. And in the process, people are humahanga sila, matapang ito, magaling ito, inaaway hindi lang yung China, kundi pati itong maliliit, no? Now, as I'm saying today in my column, tama yung sinasabi ni Kaidi, alam natin ang nangyayari sa bayan. Dapat ipaalam natin kay Pinoy na alam natin ang lahat. Kaya huwag tayong kwekwentuhan. Ha? Huwag niya kwento sa atin. Yung alam na natin, sabihin doon sa nagugutom, oy, busog kayo. Yung mga walang bahay, walang damit. May bahay kayo. He's telling us what we know to be true or that which is not even true. Yun ang problema niyan. Kaya nga, ang halala natin is one election where we are told what our vote was, whom we voted for.
Okay.
Kinikwentuhan lang tayo ng lahat. So I think this must stop. No? Ang bayan, ang dapat makatayo dyan, nakatitig kay Pinoy, oy, huwag kang mambobola dito kasi alam namin ang pinag-uusapan dito. If you have nothing good or truthful to say, get out of the room.
So how would you account for the so many clappings during the song?
Mas produced naman yan. That's hand applause. Meron pang leader dun sa...
So may pala.
No, but before I end up now, merong halimbawa, for two saunas, he dwelt on one completely... insignificant issue, yung wangwang. Tinanggal niya yung wangwang, ha? Kasi baka nga kung may wangwang ka, hindi ka naman nakakalusot sa traffic, no? Kaya, yeah, no? So, anyway, but tinanggal niya, and he made a capital issue out of it, which is nonsense. Because if you're president, your time is not your own. You cannot afford to be delayed on the road because state business is waiting. May crisis dito, crisis doon. Kailangan ka, wala ka kasi nasa kalye ka struggling like the ordinary mamamayan with traffic.
Okay.
No, sabi ano. Mm-hmm. But the real reason was never explained.
What was the real reason?
Physically unable to bear the noise of the wangwang. May sakit yung mama.
Mm-hmm.
Kaya hindi pwede yung ingay na yun, tinanggal niya, pagkatapos sinabi sa bayan, ito, maalay ko sa inyo kasi gusto kong pare-pareho lang tayo.
So malaking utang na loob pala ng taong bayan niya.
Malaking panloloko, ibig sabihin.
Okay. That's a nice. That's something to write about, no? Especially for the Daily Tribune. Anyway, Professor Heydarian, being a political scientist that you are, how would you compare the delivery of the State of the Nation address in the Philippines with that of other countries? You have the State of the Union address and so many.
Right. una-una, no? Parang I feel like triple minority today. Puro kayong Bicolano, ako lang yung Ilocano dito, no?
You can be a Bicolano by affinity.
Born, Quezon City.
We will make you a Bilocano.
Bilocano.
Bilocano din.
Right. And purong senator yata din nandito. Well, ganito na lang. Ako lang yata nag-vote kay Aquino dito sa place na to. But
hindi
but,
ka nagsisisi?
This is 2010 pa, no? Oh. Bata pa ako nun.
Okay. Oh. Okay.
Right.
Yeah, okay.
Of course not. No. Today, meron akong op-ed sa CNN, and yeah. Basically,
pakilapit
yung argument ko is that what's unique about Aquino is that siya yung nag-introduce na what I call moral politic. No, I meron tayong real politic. We have os politic, but he introduced I think new phenomenon into the Philippines called moral politic. For me, moral politics or moralizing politics, it's a double-edged sword. On one hand, it gives you the strength and the political will to go against corruption, to fight against, you know, forces that prevent change and reform. Pero meron din siyang other edge. No? The other edge is that pag feeling mo, you're the angel, you're good, and other side is automatically the evil, never ka open sa criticism. And isa yun sa frustration ko sa administration na to. Kaya nga tama si Senator Tatad, sometimes the tendency of Aquino is to be a little bit hubristic, no? Yung unwillingness to accept criticism. And whenever you're criticizing, automatically you're out of the circle. I had some experience like that, you know, they're okay with you when you agree with them and everything like that. Once medyo nagkikriticize ka, iba na. I don't think that's a good way for leadership. Generally, ang sense ko is 6 years is not enough to change a country. Particularly, sa dami natin problema dito, no? You have problem in Mindanao, you have a new problem with China, not to mention our economy, etc. Pero na-realize ko, in the case of the U.S., 6 years ito ni Obama. But look at how much he has achieved in the last 6 years, no? He was able to push for major legislations that are cleared by Supreme Court. I'm sure yung same-sex hindi ganun ka-popular among us here, but nonetheless, this is a huge issue for a lot of Americans. He won on the issue of Medicare, so nag-introduce siya ng healthcare, which is not present in the U.S., but present in a lot of countries. He made peace with Cuba after 60 years. He's making peace with Iran after 30 years. So a lot of achievement actually in 6 years. So I don't think, now I think 6 years is not an excuse not to do much. I think you have to be fair to Aquino that in his 6 years, in fairness naman, pinataas na yung investment grade status natin. But did he increase investment inflow? Medyo wala. Did he increase unemployment and poverty, decrease poverty and unemployment rates? Medyo wala. So I think what happens is that under this administration, a lot of good intentions, a lot of moralizing. But if you look at the outcomes, the final outcomes, it's a mixed record at best, no? Kaya nga, bati ako na nag-vote sa kanya back in 2010. Sometimes I have a difficulty defending him. Even on foreign policy issue, which is something I really focus on.
Yes.
If you look at the arbitration case, sangayan ako na kailangan yung modern international law, yung basihan ng claims, no? Maritime entitlement claims, maritime claims. Pero pag titignan mo, sa tingin ko lang, ha, we are also moralizing our foreign policy in a way that makes us completely unique. Even the Americans sometimes scratch their head over how we approach our foreign policy. We talk about David versus Goliath, might versus right. Pero kung titignan mo, foreign policy is much more complicated than that. That's why I'm saying, if you want to know how to deal with China, look at other countries who have trouble with China. Malaysia, Vietnam, Japan. And if you compare us to all of these countries, tayo lang walang high-level engagement with them. Nang Malaysia, nag-visit si Xi Jinping doon. Japan, a very arch rival of China, they're now talking finally. After 4 years, their foreign ministers are talking. Their prime minister, a very nationalistic guy, was willing to withstand criticism at home to meet Xi Jinping last year. And since then, at least their defense ministry and Coast Guard are talking. Vietnam, last year, muntik na giyera sila with China. But they have three different hotlines. When they have conversation between their defense ministry, their foreign ministry, agriculture ministry, their party chief met Xi Jinping, their president meets Xi Jinping. Philippines, do we have a hotline with China? God forbid, may siraulong kapitan dyan sa West Philippine Sea, nanggugulo siya, may conflict. Can Aquino call Xi Jinping and said, let's control this? None, not a single hotline. Has Aquino held a single summit with Xi Jinping? Not. Why? Because sinisabi niya, bully sila eh. We don't talk to bullies. Mm. You see, when you moralize foreign policy, you may also damage national interests. Anong national interest natin? To manage the conflict. let's be realistic. Even if lulusot tayo dun sa question ng jurisdiction, may 3 months pa bago mag-decide. And then, another perhaps 3 months before there will be a discussion of oral arguments on merit. Mm-hmm. And then, China will be given time to respond. Baka by the time may resulta na, wala nang natira dyan sa South, sa West Philippine Sea.
Okay.
In the last 18 months, let me just give you facts. In 18 months, China has reclaimed 810 hectares. More than all of the islands combined, the naturally formed islands. Mm-hmm. No? But in Vietnam, nagre-reclaim siya kaso tahimik lang sila. No? Taiwan, which controls Ituaba, Taiping, has spent $100 million to make their port facilities and airstrip even more advanced. So now they can put large aircrafts and even frigates there. But in Malaysia, even the Malaysians, if you go to Layang Layang, it's like golf course resort. I mean, it's beautiful. They have airstrip and advanced. Tayo, ano meron? Sierra Madre? It's a rusty ship, relic of Second World War. Only now, after 16 years, we're beginning to put some ventilation there kasi kawawa yung mga troops natin dyan. Makano bang ginagastos natin dyan sa arbitration? Yung lawyers pa lang natin, millions of dollars. Yung procedure arbitration, tayo nagbabayad lahat yan. Mm-hmm. Kasi may, in China, binoycott niya.
May I ask
right.
Yes, a question?
Sure.
What you are saying is very true. But does your president know what you are saying? Does he know the portent that we face in the very near future? When America will intrigue us, will arm us, arm, quote unquote, to fight China? And America will want us to fight China, but America will never fight China. And China will not fight America. And America will want us to fight China and the other countries. Do you think Noy know these portents that we face?
I mean, ganito na lang. Ang feeling ko style ng akin at music. They'll allow all of you to talk, but does it really enter or go on the other side? Yan ang hindi ko masabi. So far, it seems medyo hardline yung position ng akin. We don't talk to China. And I think that's something that is not right.
So yeah. I think the president should let the Filipinos know what we face. Mm-hmm. When he is no longer president, what is going to happen? He should let us know about it. And he should see to it that the man who is going to go after him, will be president after him, should know these things, should know the truth. These are the things that we should read between lines mm-hmm. in the art of geopolitics and foreign
relations.
So I think it will be proper for the president to let the Filipinos know the state of this nation after he's gone.
May pagkakaiba po kasi yung president who will succeed him and those who will go after him. Mabuti na yung maliwanag yun. Okay? Hindi po ba?
Well,
yung both. Magsasucceed.
Succeed. Who is going to be the president after 2016?
Okay. Yes, Senator.
I would like to take a little from Professor's angle that the Philippines does not have so much channel of communications with China. I arrived thinking just now that there is one channel, Professor, that the president or any administration may take in relation to this Chinese problem, and that is the Chinese community in the Philippines. The top 40 or 100 richest Filipinos who are Chinese, who are now not only in the Philippines list, but in the Forbes. Mm-hmm. Forbes yes. list are Filipinos who became richer in the last 5 years of Aquino. Because of the 5 years of Aquino, they became triple rich to arrive at the Forbes list. Can be topped by the administration or mm-hmm. by any government or president who may come later to be a channel of communication to the Chinese government. Because they're, you know, the Chinese are very clannish.
Okay.
They can listen to their... In fact, I know that these Chinese people all over the world maintain a line to their mother country.
Okay.
I think they have laws that these Chinese outside the China and doing business, successful business in other countries, are even obliged to support China.
Mm-hmm.
Of course, the details we don't know, but the principle is there that they are obligated. Uh-huh. In fact, when you go to China, there is always in a big city a hotel that is called the Chinese Overseas Hotel, meaning reserved for Chinese who are doing business successful, Singapore, Philippines, whatever, and they have a corresponding obligation. I think the government can use that channel.
All right.
On, under professor's idea, opening more channel of communication.
Yeah. May I remind our friends in the audience, we only have one forum. There's only one forum at Tapatan's Aristocrat, so thank you very much. Senator Tatad, you were once head of the Foreign Relations Committee. How would you describe the kind of foreign policy that we have today from your time?
Do we have a foreign policy today?
So I heard.
Well, I like the presentation of Richard here. Talks of moral politics. I spent all my years in the Senate talking of morality in politics, because I had no effect on the government because I was not in charge. I think Aquino's so-called moralistic politics is not really a moral stance, it's propaganda stance. It's like instrumentalizing the church. After Aquino died, they used the altar to move the sentiments of the people. Now, they found a very good issue, which is corruption. And so the slogan is rather stupid, but people took it, no? Kung walang korup, walang mahirap. Which is really stupid. Any grade school student who analyzes it will see that hindi naman totoo ito kasi corruption does not derive solely, poverty does not derive solely from corruption. It is corruption is a contributing factor, a big one. If it is a cause, it's only one of the causes. So when you try to capture this in that slogan, talagang naglulukuhan lang tayo rito, no? And then Dang Matuwid has to be judged not in terms of the articulation, but in terms of what is being done. For instance, you have how much for the CTC this year? 80 billion plus? And saan na pupunta? Magkano ba ang sumasabit sa bulsa ng mga in charge dyan, no? Okay. DSWD used to be a 6 billion agency under GMA. Now I understand it's about 102 billion. Anong pakinabang dyan? Saan napupunta yung pera? Now nakita natin yung pagsabog ng DAP. Saan ba napunta yung pera? Magkano ba until now? Nobody has the exact figure kung magkano ang napunta sa DAP. At bakit si Abad na hindi pa nakakulong? No? These are the issues. Kung may moral politics, may substance. May makikita tayo. Yung defense contracts na pinag-usapan yan, 28 defense contracts unsigned by the president. Ayaw niyang pirmahan kasi sabi niya, bahala na kayo dyan, baka sumabit pa ako. What kind of government is this?
Really?
Yeah. There's a Wall Street report which says a particular law approved in February 2013 has remained unsigned by the president. That's why hindi raw makagalaw. You know, a law that is not signed by the president in 30 days becomes a law. It lapses into a law. Ano bang, all these very basic things, wala.
Okay. So, ito, malaking problema talaga to.
Malaking problema. But your question is about foreign policy.
Yes, of course.
Bakit tayo nagkaroon ng kaaway na malaki? The problem with China has been there since the 50s. The maritime dispute has been there. Dito nag-aaway. magkaibigan tayo, yung sinasabi na Richard, all the other countries may points of contact. Wala tayong hotlines, ano? Kasi, kahit niya kay Obama, wala tayong hotline, I think, no? Si Obama may hotline sa atin.
Iba yata yun.
No. Yan ang basic problem. There's no concept of state to begin with, no? Concept of state, yan ang unang nasa utak ng gusto maging presidente. Because you relate to other states. You relate to your people who compose an important, a major element of the state. No? Pero kung wala kang konsepto niyan, ang tinitina mo, yung columns na lumalabas tungkol sa'yo, laban sa'yo, o yung headlines, etc. We run government through the press. That's the basic problem. Even our foreign policy, especially, our relations with China. I said, whenever Del Rosario and his subordinates talk, they talk like master sergeants leading a military campaign. No? Oh, they're not diplomats at all.
And that's the problem. That's the problem. Senator Siga, coming from where you are as a former senator, ito bang mga ganitong sitwasyon nangyari nung panahon ni Tita Cory? Dahil Tita Cory was so popular at the time.
Well, the thing that I can remember regarding the foreign country problem was the U.S. military bases.
And you were part of those who signed.
Part. Yeah, it was the big event that in 1991, the military bases agreement was expiring. And the renewal thereof was being asked of the Senate for ratification.
Yeah.
And wherein the 12 senators at that time rejected the renewal or extension of the military bases. And humbly, I was one of those who voted, because as I said, in my vote, the two of us, the children of Senator Tanyada and myself, my vote could not have been interpreted any other way, because my mother was very active in the anti-basis coalition.
Mm-hmm.
It was against the so many organizations that was to be subservient to a foreign country.
Yeah, but Senator, do you have any regret signing that?
I have no regret.
You have no regret.
I have no regret at all. And in fact, I am happy to say, without naming names, that some of those who voted for the renewal are even joining us now. Mm. As I think they have come to realize that we stood up on our feet at the time, mm-hmm. up to now. And it's just sad that the Edgar has been born in a way. Resurrection of the military or an intervention of any foreign country to bring military supplies or equipment to the country.
So you think the ECA was a step in the wrong direction?
Yes. In fact, there is a pending case now, as I see it, in the Senate, in the Supreme Court, and two signatories to the 12 are signatories in that petition.
One of them is Bobby Tanyada.
Bobby Tanyada and Rene Sagisag.
Uh-huh. Okay.
So I think during our time, that was the major foreign policy issue. In fact, where President Cory marched under the rain.
Yeah, I remember. Under the rain, Tita Cory marched
from Luneta to the Senate.
Uh-huh. Together with Speaker Monsing Mitra.
My own decision was one of the hardest decisions that I had to make, because if you will remember, I would not have been a senator if she did not ask me to run. And I, of course, I owe her my position.
Conscience vote.
And you'd rather be in the disgrace of the president rather than your mother.
Yes.
Motherland.
Okay. And I am happy to say that my mother, although in the wheelchair, just like Senator Tanyada, the old man Tanyada, still witnessed her son's vote on such an issue that she had long worked for.
Uh-huh.
While you are on this point,
yes, please.
Let me ask you a question.
Pakilapit lang po ng microphone.
What did Cory tell the senators when she went up to the Senate before the vote or during the vote?
I think it was before the vote. Before the vote. Well, Corey expressed actually through her action by gathering a rally in Luneta and marching to the Senate under the rain. I think that was her strongest message. President Salonga received her, but some of us were not present anymore. And of course, I don't know, because Senator Maceda one time when these 12 magnificent senators, as they like to call it, or some they call it the Dirty Dozen, when we have meetings, Senator Maceda would like to recollect that there were some senators who were swaying at that time.
Really?
They were swaying. He said two or three senators.
And that would have made the difference, right?
No more, because the required was only 9.
Ah, yes. Okay.
But, that's Senator Maceda's story. But Corey, of course, did not expressly force us. She talked to us one by one, even before that rain march in the rain.
Uh-huh.
And, I suppose each one of us answered her in our own way. And my principle is I really have to take the country's interest first.
Okay.
Sabi nga ni Kuya Eddie, not only for my mother, but for the motherland.
Yeah, Richard, brief
which
reaction.
Which is so apt.
Yeah. Yes, please.
Ganito ang problema sa akin administration sometimes is that they give very false impression. Una, for instance, the arbitration case. The United Nations Convention on Law of the Sea, wala siyang mandato sa issue ng sovereignty claims. So ang dinedebate lang natin dyan, yung 9-line ba ng China, consistent? Yung mga isla pinag-awayan natin, rocks pa sir atolls? Pero hindi ito yung away na sasabihin ng korte, oy, sa Pilipinas to, umalis ka dyan, China. International Court of Justice yan. Pero para sa tayo ng China, hindi tayo agree dyan. Pangalawang problema, minsan parang sinasabi ng gobyerno natin na ang mga Amerikano, they're on our sides. Pero actually, kung titignan mo yung position ng US, wala silang position dun sa sovereignty claims. Neutral sila dun. Di nila sinasabi sa Philippines to, sa China to. Klarong-klarong Obama administration, State Department dun. I was in a conference in Harvard a few months ago, and Joseph Nye, our moderator, was a former assistant secretary. He clearly said, ang position natin dapat katulad ng Mischief Reef incident. Naalala niyo, 1994, 1995, pag kinuha ng China sa atin, anong ginawa ng US? Sabi niyo, pag-usapan niyo. Noong 2012, Scarborough Shoal, kinukuha nung China sa atin. Anong ginawa ng US? Pag-usapan niyo. So multiple instances, klaro ng US hindi nagtitake ng position. Ano bang interest ng US? Freedom of navigation. Ang ayaw ng US, magkaroon ng giyera. Ang ayaw ng US, ang China, kontrolado niya yung supply lines or yung flow of merchant fleet and military. Pero wala siyang take doon sa sovereignty claims natin. In fact, sinasabi ng Obama administration, parang hindi covered ng Mutual Defense Treaty yung sovereignty claims natin sa contested islands. In short, limitado yung commitment ng Estados Unidos sa atin. Ngayon, kung titignan mo yung EDCA, there's nothing in the EDCA that clarifies American commitment to us if there's a conflict with China in the South China Sea. So ang tanong ko, then what, anong silba ng EDCA? Aside from the fact that we give the Americans access to our bases, 10 to 20 years, and we will pay for their transportation and utility costs. So, even if sabihin natin, sang-ayon ako na kailangan natin ng tulong ng US, eh sana naman pag nag-negotiate kayo ng agreement, siguraduhin nyo na tutulungan tayo, di ba? Eh kung hindi tayo tutulungan, tapos bibigyan natin ng basing access, you did not even violate perhaps your sovereignty, you didn't get any advantage. It's a self-defeating agreement. So, buti nga nasa Supreme Court pa siya. So, I think there's a lot of misinformation also anong position ng China, ang US. At saka para sa US, importante yung relasyon nila sa China eh.
Okay.
So I think we have to be very clear about those facts, and I hope Aquino will be much more forthright and honest about these foreign policy dilemmas we have.
Yeah.
Just one small point to insert. Yung Edgar, Richard, did not give the Americans access to the entire country and the right to transform it into a military base. They have already done it before EDSA came. Mm. So, yung EDSA, yun ang fig leaf, ang takip butasyon.
Okay.
Ginagawa na nila bago dumating yung EDSA. Kaya, it's a technical agreement. Di umano, ha? walang policy issues dyan eh, na, okay. na resolve. So, we really need to review the entire thing.
Yeah. Kuya Eddie, let me ask you, bago tayo magbukas ng floor for our media friends, yung bang mamasapano, yung bang BBL, do you think plus points ni Presidente Aquino?
Ayon sa mga nakakausap kong kababayan natin, sumusulat sa akin, tumatawag sa telepono, in my program. I am on the air every Saturday and Sunday at 1:30 p.m. over DCBB. They call me about BBL. The preponderant sentiment of the Filipinos is, bakit tayo lumilikha ng isang bansa dito sa loob ng ating bansa? Anong ibig sabihin yan? Ayaw nila. At hindi nila masyado maunawaan kung bakit ang ating sariling presidente ay ipinaglalaban ang magkaroon ng isang bansa dito sa ating sariling bansa. That is my answer.
What about the Mama Sapano?
Mama Sapano is a very complicated matter because we do not know the whole truth, what really happened. And I think people will not tell us the truth of what was the real situation and what did they do. Hindi natin malaman. Maraming itinatago dyan na dapat malaman ng bansa. Dapat malaman ng ating mga kababayan. For example, that is the buck stops at the president's
table.
So, kung iiwasan mo ang isang issue sapagkat baka masama sa'yo o mabuti sa'yo, eh hindi mo ginagawa ang tunay mong dapat gawin bilang isang pangulo. Yung police, yung military, alam mo, merong kasabihan, Melo, na military secret, police secret. Hindi natin nalalaman ang buong katotohanan dyan. Merong mga kawani ng police o military na naging scapegoat. Meron dyan na they were sacrificed for the benefit of the government. Pero ang katotohanan, 44 of our countrymen died in vain.
Mm-hmm. Thank you very much. Senator Ziga, Mama Sapano at BBL.
Well, yung buck stops here, principle, palagi ko napaka-glaring that the buck, in this case, stop only with Alan Purisima. In fact, I can remember correctly, there was a column which said that the ombudsman cleared or acquitted, in a way, the president in the Mama Sapano investigation.
And he dropped holds Purisima liable.
Only up to Purisima. And there was a column which said that how can you acquit or clear a president who is already automatically immune from suit? There was a legal poser or a legal question that was given forwarded to us lawyers. Now what do you call this case of a president who is already immune from suit still being cleared from
so you find it strange?
It's strange because you are dropping somebody or acquitting somebody who's already has immunity from suit.
Yeah.
If there is such a thing, this is such like an opposite of double jeopardy. You are being accused twice. Ito may immunity na, kiniklear mo pa. So you can see that the over-eagerness.
On the part of the ombudsman?
On the part of the ombudsman. In fact, I think if I read that, there were some prosecutor members of the investigation team of the ombudsman who were even vocal in asking the ombudsman herself, why are we clearing the president in this case?
Okay.
We probably end that principle that he's already immune from suit.
Okay, overkill. Yeah, thank you very much, Senator.
Double.
Yeah. Mama Sapano and BBL. Pakilinya na nung magtatanong bago umalis yung ating mga bisita.
Well, there are many inquiries, no? Inquiries by the Congress and by the PNP. My information about the PNP report is that it was heavily edited before it was released. No. In the case of, in all these inquiries, it was never asked, anong pananagutan ni Pangulo dun sa stand down order? I think I was the only one writing consistently about the stand down order to the reinforcement units as having come from Pinoy himself. I never got a denial, no comment, no nothing. And it was dined malang in all the inquiries. Now, the Senate inquiry is interesting because this was chaired by your favorite Senator, Grace Poe, who has decided to suppress the report. Okay. Instead of presenting it as required by the rules of the Senate, she sent it to the archives to be considered as reported with the concurrence of the Senate President, who is a top dog of the Liberal Party. So the one lingering question that remains unanswered and is the key to the whole thing, bakit niya in-order yung stand-down dun sa reinforcement units?
That is
because
the question.
Kung nagka-reinforcement, baka hindi namatay yung 44. Hindi lahat. Baka may mga nasagip na iba doon.
Okay. BBL. BBL naman.
We have a petition before the Supreme Court, no? Some bishops with us questioning the constitutionality of the CAB and the FAB, which are the mother documents of the Babala, of the BBL. So it is totally unconstitutional. The effort to balkanize the country, as Kuya Eddie has put it, should not be permitted. I think we can share the information that right in the proposed Islamic enclave, mas maraming ayaw ng BBL kaysa may gusto. Ang problema, people are arming themselves in the area. And ang balita namin, the Malaysian custodians of something like 3,000 AK-47 previously acquired for the MNLF have all been transferred to the MILF at this point. And there are allegedly some conversations going on now between the MI and sa Malacanang elements with the possibility of staging a panggugulo in order to prevent the holding of elections. So these are all straws okay. in the wind. No?
Okay. Yeah, thank you. Richard, short yes. rejoinder.
Very short, no? I think medyo minority yung position ko sa BBL. I am absolutely for amendments. Ang concern ko sa BBL yung indigenous people's rights, for instance. I think wala masyadong...
Wala.
Medyo... Nonetheless, I am for BBL precisely because of two things. Ang unang-una, ang takot ko is that if the negotiation of the legal framework falls apart, we don't pass this soon, it will weaken the moderates in the MILF. If you look at the leadership of MILF, they're moderates. Pero marami mga pasaway doon sa mid and lower ranks.
Mm-hmm.
So if the BBL doesn't pass, the peace process falls apart, you're gonna have more fragmentation. You're gonna weaken the moderates. And you're gonna strengthen the hardliners. Some of them may have also ties with the BIFF. Delikado yan. Pangalawa, going back to China, there's no way for us to focus on the real front, which is the West Philippine Sea, if the bulk of our defense resources, bulk of our strategic thinking, if the entire thinking of the AFP is focused on a domestic warfare. Going back to my question, if you look at all countries who are involved in the West Philippine Sea, tayo lang may domestic insurgency na ganun kagrabe. Japan, no problem. Vietnam, no domestic insurgency. Malaysia, mm-hmm. they have political crisis, but not an insurgency. The Chinese don't have a serious problem yet. Well, in Xinjiang and some areas, but not. Tayo lang, we cannot focus on the West Philippine Sea so long as we don't solve the Mindanao question. So as much as we can have many criticism of the BBL, as much as we can criticize Aquino, let's keep in mind what is the real front. It's not a war against our fellow Muslim brother. It's a war or prevention of a war with a foreign enemy that is taking away and nipping at our territorial integrity. So these are the reasons why I am for a BBL, an amended BBL, as soon as possible before things get too late.
Yeah. Thank you very much. Questions from the floor? Yes, please. Oh, yes.
Good morning. So, obviously, I'm...
Please introduce yourself.
Sorry. So, my name is Attorney Mike Yusinko. I'm with the Pimentel Institute. Obviously, there is a very low regard for the SONA at that table, and maybe even in this room. But the reality is it's a constitutional task given to the president. So my question is to the panel, what should the SONA's role be? It's unavoidable that the president delivers it every year. It's a task given to him by the Constitution. So what should the SONA be? What should its role be specifically in nation building?
Thank you. Yes. Yes, please.
Ang sagot ko dyan, kami po ay hindi nagsasabi na dapat tanggalin ang SONA. Ang SONA ay dapat magbigay ng katotohanan, hindi fiction. We should know the truth. The president should tell the truth and should stop trying to make himself look good to the people. He should tell the truth. Ito ang katotohanan. Not everything is rosy in this country. You help me. That's why I'm here before the joint session of Congress. Mm-hmm. At ito ang ating hinaharap. Yan sana ang dapat gawin. At huwag na yung pagandahan at pabunggahan. Or, hindi maganda. There is a law that says it is against the law to have ostentatious display of wealth. Mm-hmm. They are all displaying their wealth every time SONA comes.
Kuya Eddie, do you expect the president to say three little words like, I blew it? You don't know.
Well, you don't have to say it in so many words. You just, when you tell the truth, you don't have to say, you know, the Americans would say, I blew it. I failed, no? He doesn't have to say that because the people know that. Now, he should be humble enough to tell the people that I'm not perfect. I'm only human. Even though I'm an Aquino, even though I'm a Cojuangco, I'm not perfect. This is what happened. And you have to forgive me for it. And we hope that in the future, the solutions will be forthcoming to be able to solve these problems.
Yeah, I can only sympathize with Senator Lito Lapid, who realized mahirap pala maging senador after 12 years in the Senate. Yeah. Yeah, Senator Ziga.
Referring to the question of my compañero, it is an event that is, to me, especially for an outgoing president, and especially so for this outgoing president, I think he is squirming on his speech. It's like a gauntlet that he has to go through. And he knows that all the attacks are known to everybody already in the room. All the criticisms that are true, especially what's happening, what are we looking at around it. The SONA is known to everybody. State of the nation, as I said earlier, is known to the ordinary man, even to the masses and to the elite. But he has to go through this procedure. But I think he's the one that is having the most difficulty to face the people. And if anybody would say that, what are the words that I am expecting from it? I would say the three words, just like President Gloria, who said the three, I am sorry. That is that word that I would expect.
Will it require so many takes or isa lang? Dahil baka niya, ulit. I'm sorry. Isa lang, minsan lang.
Minsan lang.
Okay.
Maybe, but I think if I were president, that will be the most difficult time. Mm-hmm. That will be the most difficult time, that to face all these people that you used to order around and who you know that they will be jumping ship to another party in a few hours.
Okay.
They will all be abandoning you. You know these people that...
These people always know which part of the bread has butter.
Yes, and I think they have their avenues already prepared. After your speech, we will be going there.
Okay.
That is the worst part and the most painful for the president who will deliver the last SONA.
Okay.
And I don't envy him.
Yeah. Sir,
well, we don't want to get rid of the SONA. I want to get rid of the president. Now,
this late?
Because every day counts, no? Kung may mag-abiriya yan, magkaroon ng mamasapan 2 days from now. No. Anyway, that's not the important issue. You know, the SONA does not happen only in the Batasan during the joint session of the two houses. It begins with the opening of the plenary session in the Senate and in the House.
Yes, at 10 o'clock.
In the opening, in the session of the Senate, former senators have special seats. But the fact that we are here with Melo rather than at the Senate tells you a lot. No?
That's right.
I don't want to be seen there anymore. In spite of the fact, it is a privilege. Former member of the Congress, either house, can sit in the session hall at any time he wants, provided he does not vote or speak. But at this point, we have lost interest in being seen there. So that's how much it has gone down. Now, sundan ko yung sinabi ni Senator Siga, what is he thinking of at this point? What is the king thinking about? Sabi na sa ano? This Constitution provides only for a single term presidency. But in the last few regimes we have seen, after the first term, there is a prison term. I think that's what's worrying President Aquino.
Yeah. Yes. Brief rejoinder.
Yeah, siguro. This will ruin the acronym SONA. No? But what I really want, as was said earlier, is state of the nation conversation. You know, this should be a conversation between the leader and all people, even those who didn't vote for him. It shouldn't be between Aquino and people with yellow, you know, ribbon and all.
I have the flag.
Exactly. It should be between him and the Filipino people, even those who criticize him and do not believe in his semi-propaganda or all of these. My point is that you cannot separate politics from fiction. But at the same time, there's always a gray area wherein you can make some claims and they're actually a little bit felt in reality. So I think it's important for Obama to also do what John F. Kennedy said, you know? It's not about what the government can do for you, but what the people can do for their government. But the problem is that if you have a leader who thinks he can do everything for the people and he knows it better than anyone, even his own allies who sometimes criticize him for the right reason, then you never have conversation.
Yeah.
You have him talking at people, but he has to talk with people, right? And I think the state of a nation conversation is the way forward, and we should stop these addresses that are more fiction than reality.
So what you're saying is he's more of a combination of Spider-Man and Superman?
One short reaction to that, Melo. No? I think that's what we would call genuinely too late. I was information minister for 10 years to a president who served for 20. This was a president who spoke to everyone, beginning with his critics and Kalaban. This president has not spoken to his critics, not once. They're not even invited to his press conferences.
Okay, I remember, yes, Senator.
One last question, Professor. In these dying days of the presidency, the mere fact...
What a term.
The mere fact that he is still using that yellow ribbon, yeah. I think it has been advised to him by his closest advisor, or maybe even the family, that you should stop using that yellow ribbon, which distinguishes the people who supported you, yeah, and the people who did not support you, but they are under your presidency. That is very discriminating, that he has never overcome. Everywhere he goes, we have, in my campaign for him, we were so full of those yellow ribbons which I threw away already. Even my mother, the campaign is over. You have won and you have become the president of the whole country. Why do you still insist on discrimination of that yellow ribbon? Even the cabinet ministers who go with him sometimes are forced to use someone, some big, some small, and then some will not use at all. But he's the only one using it. Up to this, he has never gotten over the discrimination to discriminate against those who did not go for him.
Yeah.
So you see, Richard, it's not whether we voted for Ninoy or not. In case you did not know, I was with Ninoy Aquino for several years. And I campaigned for Cory. And so it does not mean whether we voted for him or not. What it means is he doing the right thing for the people? Not for us, not for him, but for the people. So we should, in a democracy, I think that's the beauty in it. Although he was your manok, still you can criticize him. For not for his own good, but for the good of the country.
Would you rather have the ribbon placed the other way around? Anyway, that's not for you to answer. Yes, please.
Teddy Lechadores po ng Metro Daily. Presidente po ng Confederation of Active Media Practitioners Organization. Sa panel, ano, kung kayo po ang nasa katayuan ng Pangulo, ano po ang gagawin nyo dun sa issue ng Mama Sapano, yung Sasaba, tsaka Spratly Islands?
So marami yun, ha?
Bali, sino, tatlo po.
Sino kaya sa kanila gusto mo, priority natin?
Si Kuya Eddie.
Kuya Eddie, yun po. Oh, yun. Had you been president, or if you're president, how would you handle yung ganun?
Mama Sapano? I cannot answer that because when I become president, I mean, if I become president, problems will be different. Pero dapat ang kasalukuyang presidente, ito ang dapat tingnan niya. Sapagkat tayo po ay nanganganib bilang isang bansa. Tayo po ay natatakot na baka tayo ay isinusubo upang magkaroon ng giyera dito sa ating bansa. Yan po ang dapat huwag nating kalimutan, na tayo ay maliit, matagal na tayong tinatapak-tapakan, matagal na tayong niluluraan, matagal na tayong ginamit. E kailangan tayo po ay magising na, huwag na tayong magpagamit, huwag na nating tulutan ng ibang bansa na tayo ay gamitin, at lalo pa kung gusto nila na tayo magkaroon ng digmaan dito sa ating bansa. Sapagkat peligroso, binibigyan na nga tayo ng armas ng Amerika Yung mga ipakikilo na nilang battleship, yun ang binibigay sa atin. At
USS Tetanus.
gagamitin natin ito para magkaroon ng giyera. Sila hindi pwedeng magyera sa China. Pero tayo pwedeng giyerahin ng China. And as Churchill said, when Germany was attacking London, and Churchill said, we are not ready for war against Hitler, but we will fight him. We'll be in the beaches, we will throw stones at him, we will even throw beer bottles at him, but we will fight.
Okay?
Okay, Senator Tatad.
Hindi pa tapos yung term ni Eddie.
Okay, punchline. But seriously.
Siguro, naisulat ko ng lahat yan. Ano? Yung Saba, halimbawa, malino ang paninindigan ko dyan from the very beginning. We have to assert our rights nang hindi tayo nagkakagera. Okay? What's the other? Ano yung...
Mama Sapano, Mama Sapano, China.
Kung akong Pangulo, siguro hindi nangyari. Hindi bang nangyayari? Because yung pulis, hayaan kong mag-pulis. Ito, pinakialaman niya Hindi niya, yung chain of command dinisregard niya. Yan ang unang problema dyan. Sino nasa chain of command? DILG Secretary, PNP Commander. Pagkatapos, from there, dadaloy dun sa baba, dun sa force provider, yung SAF. No? Ang nangyari, ang ginamit niya, yung suspendidong PNP chief na walang personalidad, kapareho lang natin yun. Mga civilian tayo, papasok ba tayo doon? Wala. So, Nung ginawa niya yun, siya mismo, he assumed responsibility, diretso siya kay Napenas, yung SAF commander. Hindi dapat nangyari sa operation yan. Pero yung pinaka-importanting issue, bakit namatay? Naubos yung 44. Pinagtulungan ng MILF at ng BIFF, humingi ng saklulo, sabi nung unit on the field, malapit doon sa place of encounter, papasok ba kami? Hindi, huwag kayong papasok.
Kung kayo po ba nakaupo, tatanggalin yung mga boundaries o territory ng mga MILF?
Anong boundaries?
Kaya nga po nagkaroon ng putukan dahil may boundary po yung ano, may teritoryo yung MILF na sinasabi nila, nilusob daw sila ng mga PNP.
Hindi, may nagaganap na peace negotiations. May ceasefire pa nga eh. Pero dapat malinaw ang lahat. May ceasefire, pero malayang pumunta yung peacekeeping officers in pursuit of criminal elements. Okay. Mahabang usapan yan. Kukunbin tayo ng National Security Council para mapag-usapan natin yung lahat na yan.
Yung siya Spratly Islands po.
Yung Spratly. Ayan. Nasa cabinet ako ng unang lumutang yung kalayaan island group problem. No? So, as I said earlier, matagal na tayo, may problema sa China. Pero alam po, yung territorial disputes, bihira po ang nasesettle dyan within the lifetime of a particular generation. Mahabang panahon yan. May mga issues na nasettle dyan. Halimbawa sa in our neighborhood, Ligitan, Sipadan, the interested parties, nagkasundo sila, nadalhin sa International Court of Justice. Nagkasundo sila. Pero para magkasundo sila, nag-uusap sila. Ito na, hindi tayo nag-uusap. Arbitration, kuno, na as Professor Richard has pointed out, ang unang pag-uusapan, may jurisdiction ba yan? At hindi sila magsasabi kung may jurisdiction sila. Kukumbinsin sila ng interested parties na, oy, kayo ang may jurisdiction, maghusga kayo.
Okay.
O, pag natapos yung jurisdiction issue, the merits ng pag-uusapan. Okay. So, komplikadong issue. Ang sinasabi ng ating profesor na dapat natin paniwalaan kasi may makatotohanan, mayroon tayong mayroong kapakinabangan yung kakaroon ng mutual cooperation habang nandyan yung problemang yan.
Okay. Yeah.
Hindi dapat nauwi sa gera.
Yeah.
Ano? Halal na ba ako?
Senator.
Well, very briefly, ang tanong mo, if you were president, what will you be? If I were president, I would just stick to the truth regarding all these incidents. That is my age old, what my mother taught me down. The truth shall set you free. Mm-hmm. Mama, sa paano incident, just tell the truth. Try to accept. You're on your way out already. Mm-hmm. You may want to bring the secrets down to your grave. But many people will write about it just the same. I mean, they analyze. Mm-hmm. They will analyze all and everything will lead to you as the decision maker in these events. China issue, open up the Chinese ambassador was just on TV and he was asking bilateral negotiations with the country. Were you there in that forum?
Yeah.
He was asking very, as professor said, open a channel,
okay.
Not just through this arbitration. The Chinese are asking us to talk to them.
Okay, well said.
And as I said, I would like to thank you for inviting me today, but I have to go ahead.
Oh, last few minutes po tayo. We're closing. We're winding down.
Last two.
Yung distribute, Spratly po.
Yeah. Pardon?
Spratly Islands
po. The same as open more channels with the Chinese. Yeah.
Okay.
But also with the BBL, I have to tread very carefully because we have, in the BBL, as Professor said, he is for that, but with some amendments, I'm also especially concerned with the Sabah not being included. and that is already for Philippine territory.
Yeah.
It's never mentioned in the BBL.
Okay. Yes, please.
Pat Santos po, Tribune. Sir, for the three gentlemen, may pinagmamalaki si Pinoy. Itong administrasyon niya, napakulong niya yung mga siga sa Senado.
I'm the only siga still out.
S. I'm not referring to Z. S. Pero sir, seriously, no?
I'm not just R. Yes, ano the only siga still out.
S. Bro. Seriously, sir, anong tingin niyo dito na ito, pinagmamalaki niya, dahil matuwid, na walang kurap, bagamat may hinihintay tayong third batch, ano, na may sabit daw doon ng mga alyado niya eh, na sinusupress hanggang ngayon, matatapos na yung administrasyon. Ano po yung take nyo dito, parang selective po yung pag...
Justice. Selective justice.
Sir,
Kuya.
Senator.
Oh, sige. Kuya Eddie, simulan po ninyo. Yung tatlo lang daw nasa loob eh.
Wala akong masasabi dyan. Wala akong nalalaman na selective justice. Ang nalalaman ko, meron siyang mga tao sa gabinete niya na makatotohanan, matapat, at okay. I can only count 1, 2, 3. After that, wala na. It is not all bad. He is not all evil. He has done something good. He has some people who mean good. And I cannot say that it's all bad, this government. What I'm only saying is he should heed what the people want. He should know what the people need. And at the same time, he should tell his people. Mm-hmm. Mukhang wala silang komunikasyon eh.
Okay.
Yan ang napupunan ng maraming tao. The Noynoy Aquino administration is not all bad. And I'm not saying he's a bad president. What I'm saying is marami siyang pagkakamali.
Okay. Yung tatlo lang na nakakulong ng mga senador, how do you look at it?
I don't know. It's up to the court to decide that, or the ombudsman or whatever, no? Mm-hmm. Mga kaibigan ko lahat yan. At I know who they are, and I know their parents. I know what they are. So it's not for me to make any comment there because they are my friends.
Okay. Senator Ziga.
Well, the three SIGA senators are not related to me, are not related to me.
Okay.
Melo, may pahabol. Sino daw ang presidente na nakikita dapat?
Later yun. Yun ang closing eh. Yun ang
closing.
Okay.
I commiserate with the three senators because yun again, the pursuance of justice or investigation should have continued, not in batches. Batch 1 filed, batch 2 coming, batch 3 when, we don't know. And more or less names keep coming out that I think yung to give justice to everyone, it should be allowed to pursue its course. But you know, Philippines is known for the different kind of justice, of delayed justice.
Pati raw justice ng Supreme Court natatrapik, kaya justice delayed.
Yeah, justice delayed.
Justice denied.
Justice denied. Mm. In fact, there was also one story, of course, that when the justice got sick in the Supreme Court, who got sick and he had to be carried down, he was being carried down by this security, and they let loose, he fell on the stairs, and they charge him with miscarriage of justice.
Oh, very good. Okay.
Kaya ako lagi kong sinasabi na sa wakas, matagal tayong nag-trial and error sa magiging presidente. Pag-aralan natin mabuti for next year. Sapagkat kung magkamali tayo next year, tayo nanganganib itong ating bansa. Nanganganib tayo na tayo ay gyerahin, na tayo ay itulak sa gyera, tayo ay gagamitin na naman ng mga dambuhalang mga puder sa buong mundo.
Okay.
Ang sa akin, we need a strong president. We do not need a strong man. We need a strong president. Pag ikaw nagkamali, kahit na ikaw ay kapatid, kahit na sino ka man, kung nagkamali, dapat dalhin ka sa husgado. Everybody should be punished if you did wrong. And the court should decide that, kahit na sino ka man.
Okay.
Kaya tama yung ginawa ni Noynoy Aquino siguro, pero huwag niyang pakialaman kung ano ang magiging judgment ng mga korte.
Well said, Senator Kit. Dun sa selective justice daw. Yung three senators inside.
Mga kakilala po natin at mga kaibigan natin na nakalulungkot, this first time na nakaupo ang senador, nakulong ka. Kalulungkot sapagkat dapat pinapayagan muna maging pangulo bago ikulong. Okay. But in any case, the real issue is hindi yung selective justice. Kung walang kasalanan, lalabas din yan. No? Kung may kasalanan, kahit na hindi nauubos i-prosecute, hindi mo pwedeng sisihin yung nagpo-prosecute. No? Pero ang nakalulungkot dito, dahil halimbawa sa DAP, hanggang ngayon, hindi natin alam kung ilan ang nalustay dyan, kung magkano. May order ang Korte Suprema, which has declared the DAP unconstitutional, to prosecute all those involved in the misuse and manipulation of the DAP funds. Hanggang ngayon, kahit isa, wala. Yun ang dapat singilin natin si Aquino.
Okay. All right. We're winding down. Last question for the panel. A political scientist said there are no political parties in the Philippines, only political clans. If you look at the Congress from 1900s, you get to see familiar names. They only changed political party affiliations. How do you look at it?
Iyan ang sinasabi ko na 2016 should be a red letter year for this country. Piliin na natin ang dapat. Huwag na nating isipin yung partido, huwag na nating isipin yung personal aggrandizement or personal relationship with these people. Piliin natin yung tama. We need a strong leader. Maybe we don't need a strong man, but we need a strong leader. A leader who is not a businessman, a leader who is not obsessed with material wealth. I want a leader.
So
who,
out na yung kaibigan ko dyan.
Sorry?
Out na yung kaibigan ko dyan.
Sino kaibigan mo?
Yung isa dyan, may kuryente, may tubig, may karsada.
Walang political interest, walang business interest. Let's just have somebody who will be the father or mother of the country. He should sign this covenant with his own blood. I will vote for him. I will work for him. And we should have that kind of leader in 2016. Mm-hmm. One who is not obsessed with money. One who is not obsessed with affluence. One who has only in his heart what is good for this country. Masyado nang matagal ang paghihirap nitong bansang ito. Mm-hmm. And let the whole world know that we have our own mind. Let the whole world know that we can do it. And we shall do it. We will do it.
Okay, thank you. Senator Kit, no political parties but clans?
Yan,
the view of the presidency.
Yan ang sitwasyon natin dito. We have abolished the institutions. Wala tayong political parties na matino. The president gets to have a party around which everyone else gravitates. Kasi ang kapangyarihan. And that phenomenon has been adopted in Africa. And they have called it the Filipinization of their political parties. Kung yan ay nakatulong sa atin o hindi, malinaw siguro sa bayan yan, no? Pero yung hinahanap ni Kuya Edding leader, baka wala na yan. Kung yun ang iboboto ni Kuya Ed, yun lang, baka his last vote the last time was really his last vote. Wala na siyang iboboto, no? Pero hinahanap man natin yan, dapat maniwala tayo sa papel ng mga institution. Palakasin natin ang institution. The institution should be stronger than the individuals in any functioning democracy. Kung hindi tayo mag-invest dyan, wala rin tayong aanihin. No? Pero that requires a lot of education of our people. One movie says, how long does it take to produce a good butler? Sabi nung butler, I think it was Anthony Hopkins playing the role, at least 500 years. No?
Mm-hmm.
How long does it take to produce a good political institution? Maybe a little more than that.
Anybody in mind in the horizon for the presidency?
I respectfully decline the nomination.
Senator Vic.
Well, again, as a product of a senator mother, the first woman bar top notcher of the Philippines, used to tell me from the time I was young up to the time I became a senator, the office should be the one seeking the man. It's not the man or men who will be seeking the office. Do not present yourself. The office that is vacant will look for the proper man or to be elected. Yun ang sana ang principle natin. Kasi ito sa ngayon nakikita natin sa horizon, all the aspirants who wants to become president, presenting themselves without the program, presenting themselves. I want to be president. I can be president. People are clamoring me to be president.
Oh, may naririnig ng mga boses, no?
May mga naririnig na boses. Yung pangalan niya sinusulat sa langit na eh. Nakikita na niya na eh.
So, what
I'm saying is, I think we revert back to that.
Okay.
The office will seek the man.
Yeah.
Iba yun eh. Kasi, ang gusto sabihin, yung office, is yung mga tao, the people, is looking for the right man. Hindi
okay.
Yung presenting.
All right. Professor.
Yeah, I'll make it quick kasi paalis na sila, no?
Paalis na, baka tayo
matira
dito.
Yeah, I mean, it's quite unfortunate from my point of view, no? Na isa lang sa top 10 contenders or top 6 contenders comes from a political party. And yung leading sa survey ngayon, ayaw niya makialay with and wants to run independent, which says actually walang nangyaring political development sa Philippines. It's still personality-based. Minimum lang requirements ko sana sa elections, mandatory yung debate. Kasi kung hindi sila mag-debate, wala na eh, papogi at saka paganda lang mangyari dyan. Eh, wala nga silang political party, so we don't know what they stand for. At least in a debate, we'll get to know. I mean, I've been analyzing elections all around the world. Even in the Middle East, they have mandatory political debates for candidates. Parang tayo lang yata wala among Asian countries. So, if you don't have debates, you don't have political parties, wala. Purong completely personalistic.
Okay.
Yan. And
maliwanag
that's
yun.
Not good for me. Walang informed choice.
Pahabol, do you see a Donald Trump in the Philippines?
Alam mo, thank God, medyo mukhang mas matindi yung elections natin kaysa US. I mean, the way I look at it, oh my God, kaya pala ganyan tayo kasi yung democracy natin galing sa US. Theirs is terrible. And thank God, wala tayong ganun version. No? I think medyo may palapre de honor pa tayo.
Yeah, we have some nuts anyway. Mga kaibigan, I'd like to thank our guests who took time out to be with us. Huwag po kayong tatayo muna at magpipicture taking tayo. I'd like to say thank you to everyone who joined us. Next week, we will talk about a serious matter, which is water shortage. Okay? So maraming salamat po. Maganda.